Hey everybody, it's Driver's Ed, y'all. So you can tell from the title of the video, I'm going to do the top 20 trucks of Hot Wheels Monster Trucks line, 164 scale for 2020. I've mentioned this before, I think this is probably the best year that Hot Wheels has ever had making monster trucks, whether they had the Monster Jam contract or not. And I think there is a reason to this, which I'll get into, but I looked at all the releases they had. This includes the main line, as well as the exclusive to doubles packs, the exclusive to the Target 5 packs, as well as the subsets. Like, you recently saw the O'Reilly Auto Parts exclusive trucks, the WWE trucks, what else? Here in front of us, the SpongeBob trucks, and then the Super Mario trucks. I think that covers all of them. So out of all those releases, I couldn't really narrow it down to 10. So this is going to be my top 20 trucks released. And again, like I said, I think this is the best year Hot Wheels has ever had for monster trucks, making monster trucks ever. So so if you saw my previous video, I kind of made this chart. So out of these charts, 75 trucks they've released in the main line. I do have all of them except for a few, but I can tell you the few trucks I do not have aren't making my top 20. The Radical Racer I don't have. Unfortunately, I couldn't find that, but I do have it in car form. It's like a rat kind of, so it's a Hot Wheels original cast. They kind of took it from the, you know, the 99 cent car version, which this is, and made it into a monster truck. So very cool and innovative, but I do know that's not going to make my top 20. As well, I don't have another Hot Wheels original cast, but I do have it in the... Now, this is the Hot Wheels ID car, so this one costs money. I'd say it retails for about $6, but the monster truck version is the same cast, is my understanding, just a different color scheme, but this it's called Scorpedo. This one is not making my top 20, so I do not have it yet in the Monster Trucks line, but I should be able to find it soon. The other two trucks I'm missing the Invader, which I feel like it was a red Invader. That color scheme was very weird. That's not making my top 20. And then the only other one I'm missing out of the 75 that were released, which again, if you see my chart, the ones highlighted in yellow are just new decos from last year or previously. For instance, the Mega Rex Chrome is a new deco, and then the green is a brand new concept or cast. So I do have all the greens and yellows other than those four trucks. Did I just say the Twin Mill? So yeah, the fourth one is the Twin Mill Drag Race one, but that one can be grouped in with, when I talk about the drag racing setup, that can be grouped in with that. So it's kind of technically on the top 20, but you'll see in a bit. But those are the four trucks I don't have. Again, the white ones, they don't count for 2020 because they are carryovers from 2019. So yeah, that is the breakdown of how I'm going to do the top 20. Okay, even though I am doing top 20, I do have some honorable mentions. So, trucks that did not make the list. The Motosaurus, I really like this. This was a doubles pack exclusive. This is probably my favorite Motosaurus. They did have a five pack exclusive that looked pretty nice as well, but I do prefer this better. I just think the color scheme and the design is really cool. So, that is the Motosaurus. Other Jeff Hardy, this is a WWE truck. I think the pattern, I know this is some of his face paint looking stuff, but very cool. The Jeff Hardy truck, it is the C10 Chevy body. That's an honorable mention, as well as from Case L, the two school, brand new casting, school bus casting. Surprisingly, did not make my top 20, but honorable mention. And then finally, the Piranha. I really like this. I don't know. It's really cool. I don't know. It's original. So again, I'm not sure if they made this in the 99 cent car version. I would guess they did, but I haven't seen it or I don't have it. So let me know in the comments if they made this, but this is an honorable mention. And then, before I get into the top 20 countdown, I will mention why I do think this is the best Hot Wheels monster trucks, best year ever for Hot Wheels making monster trucks. I try to, if you go to brianzpatton.com, you can look at all the previous years and try to pick out the best year that they had previously. I don't know what I would say previously before this year. I would probably say 2007, just because that's the year they did the WWE Smack Packs, and those trucks were awesome. They're hard to find. They're kind of rare. You know, you have the Stone Cold, you have the Rey Mysterio, the Triple H, which I wish I had the Triple H. I do not have that truck. So if you have that truck, leave in the comments. If you have an extra one, definitely leave in the comments. That is the one I'm definitely looking for. I do have The Rock. I do have John Cena. I do have others, I believe. Rock and John Cena. Oh, Stone Cold. I have that one. So, anyway, I would say 2007 is probably the previous best year they've had. Other than the Flag Series. Maybe the Flag Series might have been better than 2007. But I'm talking about the Flag Series where it was actually cloth flags. But, yeah. Leave in the comments. Let me know what your favorite Hot Wheels year of release was. But, honestly, there's a reason I think Hot Wheels went above and beyond for 2020. And now, this is why. Now, obviously, everybody knows the history. Hot Wheels had the Monster Jam contract until last year, 2019. So Spin Master got 2019, and I think Spin Master's first year, they did a good job, right? They put out the product. They got it out to the stores. They were under the gun. This was the first year they're doing it, so they had to do well, right? They had to start well, and I think Spin Master did a good job last year, 2019. Hot Wheels, they made their original trucks. They got the Bigfoot contract. They put out the Bigfoot. That was probably the most exciting truck they had last year, but they, you know, they started putting out trucks, and I think at the end of the year, I think I would say Spin Master edged out Hot Wheels for 2019. They barely, I think Hot Wheels had a good showing, but Spin Master had a better showing. So I would say, in my opinion, Spin Master edged out Hot Wheels last year, 2019. So, as most good companies do, after thinking they got edged out, they probably realized that what they did was they came out guns a-blazing, went full out, and they increased their graphics. Their graphics got better for 2020 across the board. They got innovative. They made new casts, as you'll see in my top 20. They just went all out, made great new subsets. Obviously, the best subset exclusive, I feel, for 2020 was, as most people would agree, the O'Reilly's Auto Parts exclusive, like the Mopar, and you got the Borla and all those trucks. So they really went out swinging, you know, made new casts for some of the Marvel trucks, just awesome releases. So they said, hey, we may have lost 2019. We're going to win 2020. And they did. They went over and above and beyond. And in my opinion, destroyed Spin Master in 2020. Again, Spin Master, I think, had some issues, People blame the distribution. I've seen comments where they said it's because of COVID, but here's the real deal of COVID. What in actuality COVID would have affected, honestly, it would have affected, and most likely Spin Master, I think they are producing in Asia, if I'm not mistaken, like Hot Wheels is. What you'll find is the Asia factories, they probably were closed at the most 6 weeks, but most likely the factories were closed due to COVID for a month, or maybe even two, three weeks to a month. I would say, if I had to guess, at the most, they were closed a month, right? But potentially 6 weeks, okay? So what you have is, you have production closing down, but what they do is they schedule way in advance. So what hits the stores has already been produced. So when COVID hit in the U.S., let's say March, early March, mid-March, Spin Master and Hot Wheels, they already had trucks that were going to go to the stores. So, the factory shutdowns, let's say, if I had to guess, the factory shutdowns were in February to March, right? So February to March, it was closed a month or 6 weeks at the most. So then you got, when the factory started open, they had orders they had to fulfill. So what they did was, as soon as the factories opened, they busted their buns to produce the trucks that were on back order that they needed to produce. So really, the factories, they're closing. It would only affect just slight, like probably only like a couple weeks. Like let's say, my guess they would only be a couple weeks delayed to the stores, really. Because the time they're closed, once they open, they know they have to work around the clock to bring up, get that production back, right? If they were behind on production, which they probably were, closing, let's say they closed a month. They were probably behind on production a little bit. So when they opened, they busted the buns, got the production out. So and what you'll see with Hot Wheels, you'll see that. In the stores, there might have been a delay for a certain case by a couple weeks, and that's it. And then they caught up. So by now, it's beginning of October. They have 3 months to spare of 2020, right? But the whole, everything has been released. They've at least got it out, produced it. Now they're just distributing it to the stores. Maybe you haven't seen Case M yet in your stores, but you'll see them soon because they're already produced, right? So Hot Wheels did it. They did it. So anything about Spin Master not getting it out to stores has nothing to do with COVID. And Hot Wheels has proved them that's true. And I know from production standpoint, that's the most that COVID would have impacted is Asia production, maybe shutting down the factory for a month. And then when they reopen, they have to bust their buns to get the product out. So anyway, that's my little 2 cents on how the production was affected by COVID. Now, Hot Wheels, what I think they did for 2020, they knew they kind of edged out and lost 2019. So they came guns a-blazing. And what they put out was, in my opinion, their best offering ever. Even without having the Monster Jam contract, they had to make original trucks, and they put out great looking trucks, great looking product, great looking subsets. So let's get into the top 20. Okay, so hopefully I'll go through the higher seeds pretty quickly, meaning higher seeds like 20, 19, 18, etc. So at number 20, I have the green. So this is the same, so V8 Bomber, it's on the Hot Wheels Live Tour, or it was while it was running, and they had the chrome one, obviously, on the tour, and this is the Army Green version. I think this is a great offering, coming in at number 20, just a new deco, new color scheme for the V8 Bomber, number 20. Number 19, One Bad Ghoul. This was from Case A of 2020, so it was actually released in 2019 when I got it, but it's technically part of the 75 of 2020 line. One Bad Ghoul. This was first released in a 1/24 scale, which I was like iffy about, but when they made it in 1/64, I really liked this truck. This was the first one released, so it has the clear purple tires. I like this a lot better than the second one that was released this year. And then the graphics, obviously, are very clear. Again, Hot Wheels stepping up their game with the graphics. Very cool. This is One Bad Ghoul. Coming at number 18. When I first saw this, and I didn't even like this in the 1/24 scale, so this, again, was released 1/24 scale first. You'll see a lot of those happen this year in Hot Wheels 1/64 scales. You'll see they were released in 1/24 scale first. This is another one. Again, number 18? Yeah, number 18, the Shark Reek, the black version with the flames, very clear. This is much more clear graphics than the 1/24 scale version of this. I really do like this Shark Reek. This is probably my favorite Shark Reek Hot Wheels has ever made. So yeah, this is the Shark Reek with the flames. Number 17, I will say it's a new cast. They made two of them. This is probably my favorite one out of the two. Here's the other one, the Hot Wheels Safari. So it's a Jeep cast. The grill is really cool, as you can see. So brand new cast. You know, they have a Jeep license, so they're able to do this. Yeah, just a great cast, you know, the Jeep Wrangler. So coming in at number 17. Number 16, the Spider-Man. So the Iron Spider, I think, was the one that was released in 2020. I believe this was 2019. Yeah, I think so. But just a great cast. So the Iron Spider, this one, when it was initially released, it was released in small volume and nobody could find it. I do know there is, okay, so yeah, the fifth truck I don't have, if it's considered a 2020 truck, there's a blue one of this. So the blue one, if I had the blue one, this probably may have ranked higher. I think that blue, it was a very vibrant blue one. So technically, if it is considered a 2020 truck, it's the fifth truck I do not have, but it's the same cast. It's just a vibrant blue one. So this is the Spider-Man, the Iron Spider that was released in 2020. Again, when it was first released in low volume, then people started to find it at Target when they released those end caps, with a lot of these trucks in them. I think there was probably four of these per end cap or something like that. So it's not as rare as it used to be, but this is the Iron Spider, coming in at number 16. Okay, number 15, I will group this together, the Black and White series. This is honestly probably my favorite truck from the Black and White series. This is the Chassis Snapper. The reason being is that this almost reminds me of like the blackouts that they did. So they took a base color and then they did 3D printing black on top of it. Well, this one, instead of the base color being black, it's white, but it does have that 3D black printing, and it's just very clear, very great printing. The Chassis Snapper, you know, so again, number 15, I'll group this together with the Ringmaster, as well as the Skeleton Crew, and even the Bone Shaker. So four out of the five, I think, are very good ones. The Mega Rex was not so good, but I'll say number 15 is the Black and White series, with the Chassis Snapper being my favorite of the series. Number 14, again, I'll group it together. These new O'Reilly Auto Parts trucks, I'll group these two together. These are really a tie for me. The K&N, which is a trophy truck body, very cool color scheme. It does have the red line Goodyear tires. Again, here is the C10 Chevy Titan body with the Gulf license. So these two, I would say, is my number 14th of the year. Getting into number 13, it's a new cast. They've done this before in the car version. This is the VW Drag Bus. Very cool cast. I like how they scaled it up. I do have one of the, I think it's the Chewbacca. No, what is it? C-3PO. So C-3PO, if you have the C-3PO that they did of the Star Wars, which I think they should do another Star Wars monster truck. So if they do Star Wars monster trucks next year, they may do the C-3PO and the Drag Bus, which would be really cool. It's obviously just a gold version of this. But yeah, I really do like this new casting. It's a scaled up casting of their Hot Wheels car version of the Drag Bus. So very cool. This is coming in at number 13. Number 12, again, I'll group them together, but this is from KSA. I really did like this. This is the delivery cast, but very clear. I like this in the 1/24 scale, the Milk Monster. I think this is my favorite 1/24 scale of the delivery cast that they've released. And this is definitely one of my top for the 1/64 scale. I'll group this in with the Hot Wheels Special Forces one. You know, again, same cast, but very cool that they did the 3D printing, almost like a blackout. It does have pops of red. So that is coming in at number 12. Number 11 is the El Superfasto, which was one of the earlier cases. I think it was case C, if I'm not mistaken, but very cool. I think it translated well into the monster truck, but the best part about it is the color scheme. I think they did a really great job. Looks like a luchador right there, you know, with his mask and everything. Looks like a wrestler, a Latin wrestler with his mask. So I like how they did the clear crushers, and then the rims are kind of translucent and they match the body, and with the white roll cage. This looks really cool. So those are number 11 through 20. So now let's get into the top 10. Okay, starting with the top 10, you got number 10, Mario. This is from the Subset Target exclusive, the Mario 5 trucks. I really love this candy apple red. Oh man, this is great. C10 Chevy body. It's got Mario. It's got the coins. Looks very cool. I love how they have the blue around the wheel wells, with the gold, like gold coin rims. Just a very great truck. I'm really happy with the subsets they've released, even though these are geared towards kids, these Mario ones, I think they look a lot nicer than, for instance, the Spin Master ones. They had the zombies and hunters. I think those were a little crazy. These ones were really sleek, really shiny, nice paint job, looked overall well put together. So this is the Mario coming in at number 10. Number 9, and I think most people agree, I think this Haul Y'all cast came about because they probably heard about the ride trucks coming from Spin Master. But what I will say, if that is true, which I think it is, what I will say is that Hot Wheels, they have the means to just put together a truck. Like, hey, let's put together a ride truck. And they put it together quickly. If you'll see, this Haul Y'all was released only, I don't know, weeks after the first ride truck came out for Spin Master. It's crazy. They just did it real quick, put it together, and I think they did a really great job. I've really mentioned before that I like this insert piece better than the pickup truck version of the ride trucks for Spin Master. Looks like it's Rhino linings. It's a pickup truck that doesn't have a tailgate, so very cool. It's just a great new casting for the pickup truck without a tailgate, and then they were able to put the roll bar in as well as the seats, and it looks like it has Rhino linings. It's got that texture on the floorboard, which is really cool. So they released two this year. Again, this is the Operation Stomp from Case L, which I just reviewed, and then this is the initial one. So coming in at number 9 is the Haul Y'all cast. And then number 8, this is one that most people love. This is the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile. Just a great cast. I think they've done this before in the car version. I'm not sure exactly. But I think they executed this nice. For me, I was like, yeah, kind of skeptical about this. I thought this would be a weird truck. But I think they executed it really well. It looks really cool. So this is coming in at number 8. It's the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile. Now, number 7, we'll trash it all. I mean, again, this is a new cast, just a garbage truck scheme. It's got a moving part, kind of like the Matchbox cars. I think Matchbox made one before. Again, Matchbox is also under Mattel, just like Hot Wheels. So, very cool cast. We'll trash it all. This is my pick, number 7 of the year for Hot Wheels Monster Trucks line. Coming in at number... what was that? Number 7? Yeah, that's number 7. So, number 6... this is, again, O'Reilly's Auto Parts exclusive. It does have the Goodyear Redline tires. It's the Mopar. Very cool color scheme. Very cool. It's the Dodge Charger body. Mopar, meaning motor parts, which I just learned this year. But I've seen that name before. Hot Wheels has had the license for many years. I know they made Hot Wheels cars with Mopar. But just executed perfectly. Graphics are clear. Very shiny car. Very cool detail. You got the purple on the grill. Very cool redline tires. Again, this is my number 6 of the year. So let's get into the top 5. My top 5 for 2020 Hot Wheels Monster Trucks line 1/64 scale. Okay, coming in number 5. It has nothing really to do with the Dodge Charger RT. It is the fact that this is the they got the deep dish rims. This is the drag race setup, right? The slicks, the front tires are smaller, like, you know, smaller diameter as well as thinner. These are more wide and a bigger diameter. It's got the deep dish rims. This drag race setup is awesome. Again, I don't have the twin mill, but this would be grouped in with the twin mill. So at least I have this, I can show this. So that is the main reason this is number 5. This is the drag race setup. Again, Hot Wheels has thought outside of the box, even more so than I would say than even like the ride trucks type thing. This drag race setup is definitely thinking outside of the box, and Hot Wheels executed this perfectly. When I first heard about this and saw this, I was blown away. This is really great. Again, this leads to Hot Wheels being their best year ever for monster trucks if this is number 5. Then you got number 4. This is my favorite O'Reilly's Auto Parts. I just think it just looks great. I was not a big fan of the Camaro monster truck version until this came out. This is just perfectly detailed, color-wise, decals, clarity, the color scheme, the roll cage, The rims, great charcoal choice. It's got the tires with the red line Goodyears. Just overall, just a great truck coming in at number four. Okay, now number three. I have never reviewed these on my channel, but these are the two. Now this is the Target exclusive, the Chrome Iron Man. So brand new cast. I prefer the gold one because this looks kind of like Iron Man. So this is Case M Iron Man. And then this, my understanding, is the Target exclusive Iron Man with the chrome instead of the gold. So overall, just a really great updated cast to the Iron Man cast. Everybody knows the Hot Wheels Monster Jam Iron Man cast. But this is really just, you know, I don't even think this is their character car. Please correct me if I'm wrong in the comments if they've made this in a character car before for Hot Wheels, just the car line. But I just think this is a monster truck cast. It fits well. It looks great. Just awesome. Similar to the Hulk, how they did the Hulk last year and the Spider-Man. You know, I did the updated Iron Spider for this video. But I just think Iron Man, just a great cast. They did a great job. Knocked it out of the park, in my opinion, for Iron Man. Coming in at number three of the year for 2020. Okay, number two is a grouping as well. You guys may be surprised to find this is my number two, but obviously this is Bigfoot from last year. But this year's releases of Bigfoot, you got the Bigfoot with the white chassis, so that's grouped in with number two. You got the Bigfoot Target exclusive. I think it's Bigfoot 9, they call it. So that's grouped in with the number two pick. A recent release was this Bigfoot. I think they call it the Charlie's Angels Bigfoot from the movie. I think it's the Bigfoot from the movie Full Throttle. I kind of looked it up and I never watched that movie, but my understanding is that made an appearance in that movie. And then you have this Target exclusive. I think this is Target exclusive. It might not be, but it initially started out finding in Target and things like that. I heard maybe Best Buy as well, but I think they call it the Bigfoot 8. Now it's disputed whether this really is the Bigfoot 8, but I think Hot Wheels calls this the Bigfoot 8. Again, this is my favorite cast for the Bigfoot, the original cast. And then most recently was the Bigfoot 45th anniversary from Case L. So I group all these together. This is their number two offering. I think Hot Wheels, you know, they have the Bigfoot contract, so they're knocking it out of the park. They're trying to release a lot of these Bigfoots, and I think they're doing a good job. Again, this is my favorite casting. They've done this three times for the Bigfoot, and they did it one time. If you saw the beginning of my video, they did it with the SpongeBob. I think his name is Plankton, but yeah. So four different times they've done this cast before. So yeah, coming in at number two, it's all these, the Bigfoots just grouped together. It would be, you know, if I did them separately, you would see the top 10 have like four different Bigfoots, which I didn't want to do. So coming in at number two, might be a surprise to you, is Bigfoot. Okay, it's time, everyone. Coming in at number one. Now this, when you see this, you may be, but wait, is that a 2019 truck or a 2020 truck? Well, it's iffy, and yeah, hate me if you think it's a 2019, but I feel this should deserve to be in the 2020 because it was released in the U.S. in 2020. Now, in 2019, my understanding, it was released overseas as well as Canada, but I still love this truck. This is the Triple H. I do believe this was released in limited form in the U.S. I never found it in the U.S. The only way I got this, again, I met somebody, you know, talked to somebody and negotiated some trades with somebody from Canada, because this was found in Canada last year. So I got this before a lot of people in the U.S. did, but Canada definitely found it before U.S. I do know there was a U.S. version because I saw the back of the card. You can tell the European or the non-US version versus the US version. So there was a separate US version that was released. I never found them in my stores. I never heard about them being released near me or anything like that. So I think this is quite limited, at least in the US. So if you have this truck, you're lucky. I just really like this truck because it's so sleek. Just the color, that black matte clear coat with the white. It's very simple, black matte clear coat in the white. Now, this is the same black color as the Borla. It's the same black color. It's just that it's more simplistic, more sleek, with just having white instead of the red. So this one, obviously, you know, is in my top 10 as well, but this one being just so sleek and white, this is my favorite truck of 2020. And if you want to call it 2019, it's my favorite. It's my favorite Hot Wheels truck that they've done since they got changed into Hot Wheels Monster Trucks instead of Hot Wheels Monster Jam. So it still is. It's a great body. It's the C10 Chevy Titan body. Triple H, please let me know in the comments if you have this truck. If you don't, you need to buy it on eBay now. I don't think it's going to be released any more than it has been in the U.S. I do know the Smack Packs from 2007 that had the Triple H, which I do not have, which I would love that truck. I do know those are very rare and very limited. So get your hands on a Triple H. He is actually, even though he is married to the boss's daughter of the WWE, he was definitely one of my favorite characters that they made, the Triple H character from WWE. So it's very cool to have his truck, and the fact that it looks so sleek and so just a great looking truck. Just very simplistic, black and white. So anyway, please leave me a comment. Let me know what you think about Hot Wheels Monster Trucks for 2020. Let me know what your favorite truck is. I'm guessing it must be a Bigfoot, possibly the Bigfoot 45th anniversary. But yeah, let me know what you think of my countdown. Please like and subscribe. And as always, have a good week and rock on.